Welcome to online lecture series of refrigeration and air conditioning. Here is Professor Lakshman Mani. This is a video session on psychrometric processes. In this session, you will be able to explain psychrometric processes, air washer and mass and heat balance equations. Psychrometric processes are carried on the air which is to be conditioned in order to maintain its temperature and humidity, means moisture content. So here these are the processes which are shown here. So here are main four processes which are standard processes: process OA, sensible heating; OB, sensible cooling; OC, humidification; OD, dehumidification. Next four processes are combination of the above. So process OE is heating and humidification, OF is cooling and dehumidification, OG is cooling and humidification, and OH is heating and dehumidification. Let us see psychrometric processes on the psychrometric chart. So here process first is a sensible heating, sensible cooling, humidification and dehumidification. Sensible heating: in this process, heat is added to the air. In this, dry bulb temperature of the air is increased without changing its specific humidity. So here, air is entering at a dry bulb temperature TD1, which comes in a contact of dry heating coil, which is having dry bulb temperature TD3, air coming out at a temperature of dry bulb temperature TD2. In sensible heating, heat added to the air is given by the formula Q is equal to H2 minus H1 in kilojoule per kg. This is another formula in the form of temperature. In case of sensible cooling, the air is cooled up to its dew point temperature. If the air is cooled below dew point temperature, then here condensation of the moisture will take place. So that condition of air will fall outside this saturation curve. In case of sensible cooling, air is used to pass over the cooling coil through which refrigerant is passed. In sensible cooling, amount of heat removed from the air is given by the formula H1 minus H2. So H1 is the enthalpy of inlet air, H2 is enthalpy of outlet air in kilojoule per kg. Humidification: in this process, addition of moisture to the air without change in its dry bulb temperature is done. So dry bulb temperature during humidification process remains constant. Hence, only latent heat is added to the air, that is H2 minus H1. This is another formula, Q is equal to HFG into W2 minus W1 in kilojoule per kg, where W1 and W2 are the specific humidities of air at inlet and outlet respectively. HFG is latent heat of vaporization at dry bulb temperature TD1. Dehumidification process: in this, removal of moisture from the air without change in its dry bulb temperature is done. So dry bulb temperature during the dehumidification process remains constant, so latent heat is removed from the air, which is given as H1 minus H2 in kilojoule per kg. Methods of obtaining humidification. Humidification is achieved by supplying or spraying steam or hot water or cold water into the air. Also, humidification can be achieved by using spraying of water into the air, by using the apparatus called as air washer. This is air washer, which consists of components pump. This is a pump which is used to lift the water from the pan to the nozzle spray. Cooling or heating coil is used in order to cool or heat the air as per the requirement. Eliminator plates are provided to minimize the loss of water droplets. Float wall is here part of makeup water, which is added for any loss in case of humidification of air. So in the air washer, during the course of flow of air through the washer, air may be cooled or heated, humidified or dehumidified depending on the mean surface temperature of the spray water. So here are possible processes with the help of air washer. Let us see process 1-2, that is adiabatic cooling. This process is possible when water is sprayed at the temperature equal to wet bulb temperature of entering air. In this process, there is no change in enthalpy. H1 is equal to H2 means process is adiabatic cooling process. Process 1-3, this is a sensible cooling. It is possible by spraying water up to dew point temperature of air. Process 1-4 is a cooling and dehumidification. This is done by using water below dew point temperature of air. Process 1-5, that is humidification, is done by spraying water at temperature equal to dry bulb temperature of air. Process 1-7 means dehumidification. In this, water is used, that is below dew point temperature of air. Process 1-6, heating and humidification process, is done by using spraying water above dry bulb temperature of air. Cooling and dehumidification. This process generally used in summer air conditioning in order to cool and dehumidify the air. So here the process is shown by the point 1-2-4, that is a coil temperature. So in this case, dry bulb temperature of air decreases from TD1 to TD2 because the process is cooling. Specific humidity of air decreases W1 to W2. Here, final relative humidity of the air is higher than that of entering air, that is relative humidity. So dehumidification is possible only when TD4 means coil temperature is less than TDP1 means dew point temperature of entering air. So here this temperature are shown: TD1, dry bulb temperature of entering air, TDP1 means DPT of entering air, is indicated by the point number 3. Hence it is a TD3. TD4 is coil temperature. It is also called as apparatus dew point of cooling coil or effective surface temperature of cooling coil. In this case, resulting condition of the air coming out of the coil is shown by the point number 2 on the straight line joining the points 1 and 4. Now this is the effective process 1 to 2 because of here bypass factor. Bypass factor is inefficiency of the coil. Inefficiency is here 2 to 4. In actual condition, cooling and dehumidification process follows the path shown by the dotted line. But for the calculation of psychrometric properties, only end points are important. So cooling and dehumidification process is line 1-2. During this process, amount of heat removed is H1 minus H2 in kilojoule per kg. This is a total heat removed. This total heat has two parts, H1 minus HA, this is vertical line, so this is the latent heat part, and HA minus H2 is horizontal part, this is sensible heat part. So total heat is split up into two parts, sensible heat and latent heat. In this case, 1 to A is dehumidification process and A to 2 is cooling process. Cooling and adiabatic humidification process. This process is shown here. This is what air washer, already we have seen this. Here spray of water of air washer maintained at a temperature TL means temperature of liquid which is sprayed. That is higher than the dew point temperature of entering air, that is TDP1. Also, it is maintained lower than dry bulb temperature TD1 of entering air or equal to wet bulb temperature which TD1 of entering air. Then the air is said to be cooled and humidified. In this case, air is cooled and humidified. So this process is shown, cooling and humidification. Obviously this is adiabatic process, because since no heat is supplied or rejected from the spray water, as the same water is recirculated again and again. So process 1-3 follows a path along constant WBT line or constant enthalpy line. So in actual practice, perfect humidification is never achieved. In actual practice, here process take place from 1 to 2 is shown. Therefore, final condition of air outlet is represented by point number 2 on the path 1-3. In this, effectiveness or humidifying efficiency of the spray chamber or air washer given by the formula. Humidifier efficiency is equal to, it is a ratio of actual drop in dry bulb temperature to ideal drop in dry bulb temperature, or it can be written as ratio of actual drop in specific humidity to ideal drop in specific humidity. So inlet outlet, this is a change in dry bulb temperature, and this is the total change in dry bulb temperature. This is change in moisture content between inlet outlet of air 1-2, and this is a total moisture content change. Then the process cooling and humidification, which is done by water injection. This is called as evaporative cooling because water at temperature TL is injected, the flowing stream of dry air. So here, in this case, mass of water supplied MW, MA mass of dry air, specific humidity at entering and leaving the air are W1, W2, HW is enthalpy of water injected into the air. So here the mass balance equation, specific humidity of outgoing air W2 is equal to specific humidity of entering air plus ratio of MW to MA. Heat balance equation is given as H2 is equal to H1. Plus MW divided by MA into HFW is equal to H1 plus, it can be written in this way, W2 minus W1 into HFW. Heating and humidification process is shown here. In this case, this is a temperature of entering spray water TS1. TS2 is the temperature of leaving spray water. Mean temperature of the spray water is T3. So here heating occurs from point number 1 to 2. In actual case, during this amount of heat added to the air is H1, H2. That is H2 minus H1. This again is a total heat, is a split up into two parts as a sensible heat and latent heat. So H2 minus HA is a latent heat and HA minus H1 is a sensible heat. In this case, sensible heat factor, which is the ratio of sensible heat to total heat, means sensible heat plus latent heat. During this process, these are the parameters: mass, enthalpies, humidity, enthalpy of entering and leaving, mass of dry air. Mass balance of spray water is given by the formula MW1 minus MW2 is equal to mass of air into W2 minus W1. This is a spray water initial, this is a spray water after, this is a specific humidity after, and this is specific humidity before. So equation can be written as MW2 is equal to MW1 minus MA bracket W2 minus W1. Enthalpy balance is given in the same way, MW1 into HFW1 minus MW2 HFW2 is equal to MA into H2 minus H1. Substituting the values of MW2 in equation number 2, means this equation number 1 we can put here in this equation 2, we get H2 minus H1 is equal to MW1 divided by MA bracket HFW1 minus HFW2 plus another bracket W2 minus W1 into HFW2. Here, this is a process that is heating and humidification, which is used in textile mills for higher humidity requirement. This process is done by steam injection in the air. So this is a steam injected, supplied at rate of ms. This is the air entering, this is the air out. So process 1 to 2 is shown on the psychrometric chart. These are the parameters of air: ms mass of steam, ma mass of dry air, w1 w2 specific humidity, enthalpies h1 and h2, hs is enthalpy of steam. Here mass balance given, W2 means specific humidity after steam injection, W2 is equal to W1 means specific humidity before steam injection, plus ratio of MS by MA. Heat balance is given by the equation H2 is equal to H1 plus MS divided by MA into HS. Next is adiabatic chemical dehumidification. In this, air is allowed to pass over chemicals which absorbs the moisture content in the air. Thus, air gets condensed and gives up its latent heat. So this is adiabatic chemical dehumidification process shown. In this case, 1, 3, 2, this is the adiabatic dehumidification, but actual adsorption dehumidification is shown by this line. Now in this case, this 2 to 3 is a possible process. So effectiveness or efficiency of dehumidifier, because this is a dehumidification, that's why apparatus is called as dehumidifier. Its efficiency is actual increase in dry bulb temperature to ideal increase dry bulb temperature. So actual increase in dry bulb temperature means TD3 minus TD1. This is actual increase divided by TD2, minus DD1, this ideal increase. So at the end of this session, you can explain psychrometric processes, air washer, and mass and heat balance equations. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.